Hello everyone, welcome to the Code Code, and today we are going to see how to create a new repository and do all the actions which we do usually from GitHub command CLI, but right now we are going to do it from the PyCharm UI, because most of the project, some of my recent known projects, they have some restrictions to use this PyCharm only. So let's start. So we will create one repository. Well, we can say this is a test proj, and after creating it, it is just for the demo purpose. So I'll provide the option, let it make it private, add a readme file, and add a gitignore. Okay, let's make it none only and create a repository. So right now we have this one repository which have one main branch. Now let's go to the PyCharm. Into the PyCharm, let's create a clone repository. It's a freshly installed. So what we have to do, we have to come here, take this HTTP URL. Inside this HTTP URL, just let us check this test proj is available or not. Okay. Windows E. Okay, so we don't have this. Let's create a new folder then. Let's name it Git. Inside the Git, we will create this dummy. And we will provide this path of dummy to here, this directory. Now let's start the clone. Okay, let's start the clone. As I already provided my credential to the GitHub repository, so it should do the clone. Okay, trust all the project from Git folder. Trust Git. Great. It created a file, this readme. It didn't create. It's copied the, it cloned the file which we have here with the data demo. So now let's create a few files to check in. Let's say this is the important .py. We will add it all when we are going to do the commit. So let's leave it like this, and let's say we have this. We will create one more file, not important .py. Okay, so now we have two files, and in your scenario, you will have some modified file, or you will have some newly created file out of all those files. So what we are going to do, we will come down here. We can see this Git. Okay, we have all the things. Now let's do the Git operation. Let's do the commit. Okay, so let's see what are the files we have here. We have all these files, but what we want to clone is this important and not important. We have this gitignore file too, so we will leave it like this right now. Okay, and we'll create the commit, specify commit message. Okay, it's commit one, and we'll do the commit from here. Okay, so we have the committed change here in the initial commit. And again, we will go here, do the git, and write on the push. So this commit, okay, so after this push, it is completed. We should have the latest files here. Okay, so now we have this important.py and not important.py. Again, Let's say we don't have this gitignore file. So for this, what I'll do is I'll come here in the dummy, and what I'll do is where is this view show hidden items. Okay, it closed it. Show hidden items. What's the path of this file? How can I delete this? It is really good in the CLI. Okay, let's see from here only. What I'll do is I'll open the Git bash. Okay, so where we are, this D. Okay, let's do the ls. We do the pwd. We are in the C user. Let's go inside the D. Then we have this. What is the current path we have? This is not important. YouTube code code git dummy. Okay, cd. YouTube code goat. CD ls cd code goat. Okay, we are inside of it. We will go to the remote project. Git, and here we have this dummy. And if I do this ls-alt, so we can see we have this dot git dot idea dot dot slash. Okay, so we are not getting this dot git ignore file, but if you want to do the functionality of dot git ignore, because it is really mandatory to know, because sometimes all you need to do is to avoid some files which will be created at the runtime, or you will have some test.py, so that file you don't want to check in, but you don't want to delete that too. So you can come to the GitHub, you can come to the where is that section, GitHub current annotate shelf changes patches, where is that operation branch new tag reset show leg. Okay, show local history branch as changes. Add to gitignore. Okay, so we are here and we need to go to get gitignore. It will be fine. So whatever the file you are going to do, okay, this gitignore git ls other file lines that start with hash are commented for a project mostly in C. The following exclude pattern, uncomment then. What we will do is we will come here ls-alt ls-alt cd.idea ls. See, okay, we got this .gitignore file. So if you want to check in that, then what you have to do is, we're going to minimize it. It's not a part of, as this file, what I opened exclude, because of it, it is not letting this .gitignore file to get uploaded. So I'll remove this section, I will save it. So now you will see this .gitignore file is also there. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll do this. I'll add this commit to, do the commit. And again, I'll go to the git option. In this, I'll do the push. Okay, I got it at green. I provided the push. Fine, so let's see. I got the done status there. It must have been here. Okay, so inside the idea, I have this gitignore. Great, right? So this gitignore, if in your project, if it must to be at the parent directory, then what you have to do is you have to copy this .gitignore from the idea to outer, and you need to remove the this path from this exclude. I guess that's it. So this is the way how you are going to create a new project through UI, and you don't have to write any kind of CLI. And now you know why you are not able to see the .gitignore file. Thank you. So please like and subscribe, and also let me know if you have any other doubts. Thank you.